Hello friends, so I'm delighted to be with Dr. Pranjal Singh. He is a proud ranker, PGI rank 3. He was having the AIIMS rank 10. So he was already with us. He was our, Pranjal, you were our classroom student with us.
Yes.
Yes. And first of all, heartiest congratulations, Pranjal, on achieving these awesome ranks. How did you manage, Pranjal, all this?
Ma'am, okay, so again, like I said in the last video with Dr. Rajat, the key is to start very, very early in your internship only. I think you should start in third year only, in fact. Thing is that you have to be very regular and very disciplined in your approach, and whatever you're seeing in your postings, whatever you're seeing in your words, you should like make it a point to be on par with that and be disciplined in your approach. And I think that's the key message here, that to be disciplined in your approach and to be very regular and consistent while studying.
So, okay, so first thing he's saying that I always say the distance between the reality and destination is actually traveled by the discipline. And he has rightly mentioned that he had started early and he was disciplined. He was going to his clinics, he was learning there. And then he is also doing the academic things. Okay, so how did you manage your schedule? Like, were you able to follow a TND schedule or you were there on your own, like, studies?
Ma'am, so what TND does is that it gives you something to look forward to at the end of every week. And I think that's a very realistic target, that, okay, fine, I have to complete this subject within 1 week. And that is how TNDU helps in stay in touch with the subject, especially in I come from a place where the internship is really, really hectic, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So I did not have the time to make schedule on my own. So I was, the TND really helped me in making a schedule. And
like, you were actually able to get a direction, like which subject to start with, because I think this is the first question that comes to the student's mind, like where to start, then what subjects to follow, how much time to give, and TND will give you an answer to all these things.
Definitely.
Okay. Okay, then how did you manage with your schedule? Did you studied along with the TNDs or what you used to do?
Yes, ma'am, I studied along with the TND only. I always tried to complete my the subject or whatever the topics were being covered in the TND within first 3 to 4 days of the week itself. And on the next 2 to 3 days, I would solve MCQs related and regarding to the topic and the subjects that were being asked. So that is how I went about it, like first 3-4 days of the week were dedicated to just antrograde studying of the subject, and last 1 or 2 days were spent in doing MCQs. And I think the most important thing which I did was, after the TND, I always analyzed my mistakes. I reread the topics and I revised the TND papers and the TND notes just after giving the paper itself, so that, you know, I knew what I am doing, so that I get to know that what I am doing wrong, and I immediately fix on my mistakes and immediately work upon them so that I don't make those mistakes in the near future.
I think he has pointed a very important point. Most of us, what we do after giving a TND, we leave that subject there.
Yes, ma'am.
But the important thing is, and you will be benefited by that particular TND only when you are seeing the weaknesses, what you have done wrong in that TND, and coming back. So, he is telling you the retrograde study after TND is also very, very useful, and you are going to get benefited when you actually ponder on your mistakes, what did wrong in that TND. Okay, so that is a very good message that he has given us. And what about the visual questions, Pranjal? Like your AIIMS also gives you a lot of visual questions. How did you manage that?
Okay, so to tackle visual questions, I'll tell you something what my seniors told me. The thing is that AIIMS, you know, they take a lot of questions, images from Google itself, right? So whenever you're studying something, make sure to have your tab or phone with you and always just Google those images, because they will probably select the first image that comes on Google itself. And apart from that, I saw standard, I saw images from Robbins 1 day, 1 or 2 days before the exam. But I think the Google thing is really something which is very insightful, because that is what the AIIMS people are doing. They're copying images from Google. They even copied an image from someone's Instagram account. So, yeah.
Okay. So, do you feel that it is important to see these images in the last few days of your exam? Like, does it help looking at the images in the last few days?
Yes, ma'am, because you know, you get a visual cue, and there are so many things that you have already previously associated with the visual cue before, na, that if you look at an image, you'll like at the same time you'll remember two or three other points that you have studied regarding that topic. So I think a visual cue just before the exam is a very important thing.
So you mean to say that you are able to revise the topic as a whole?
Yes, ma'am.
It's
yes,
not
ma'am.
Just the vision, but it is also the visual question. So
yes,
you are able to integrate the theory as
yes.
well.
Yes, plus when you see the image, na, so you already try to recollect and remember what all do you know about the image and what all you know about the related topics to the image.
Yeah.
Right. So I think it's a very good and a fast and effective way to revise stuff using visuals.
Yeah, like those of you who attended my classes, I always say that visual memory is the best form of memory.
Yes,
so if you are able to remember a topic by that visual, that will always last for long.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Definitely.
Okay, then how important do you feel is giving like tests, grand tests and mock tests, how they help you, or do you feel that your time is getting wasted by giving these tests?
No, ma'am, the thing is that these grand tests, they help you analyze your mistakes, and it's very important to learn from the mistakes that you're constantly making, and it also gives you an insight into what is important and what is being asked in the current pattern and what is more likely to be asked in the upcoming exams, and that is how grand tests help you. And they also, you know, keep you kind of in the competition and in the competitive zone. Like it always keeps a check on you, okay, fine, currently I'm lacking, currently I need to work very hard. No, and also it gives you a sense of confidence also at times, so yeah.
Means it helps us in assessing ourselves, a self-assessment, plus it gives us like opportunity to ponder our mistakes, like
yes,
where
ma'am.
We are actually lacking, and we, if we have a time, we can actually improve on our
yes,
mistakes.
Ma'am.
Now, do you think that we can actually drastically improve our performance in the last days? If you are able to focus on your mistakes, if you are improving, can you drastically change your scores? Like this is the most common question that I am getting from so many of the students. They are actually worried that they are getting low scores. So do you feel that if they constantly work on their mistakes, they are keep on revising, can they improve their rank in these days?
Ma'am, I think it is definitely possible, because I think a few days before the PGI exam, I gave a PGI mock from the app only.
Okay.
So when I gave the mock, I had a rank of 700 or 800 something, right?
Okay.
So that time was really disappointed, but then I decided to make a strategy and work on the basis of the strategy. So what I decided was to, okay, I'll look at the previous PGI papers, and then I'll read only those topics, and I'll read those topics quickly, efficiently and thoroughly in a short amount of time. And just by making a good plan, a good strategy and a good revision plan, you can do wonders if you just, you know, have a plan in mind.
See, listen carefully. This is a very good and a very important message that I want to give through Pranjal, that you can actually drastically improve
Definitely.
Your performance and your score if you start working efficiently in these last days. Don't focus on the scores that you are getting now. He got a score of 700. What if he got distracted and disturbed by that score? But now he has got an amazing rank 3. So these scores can actually be changed, and one should not be distracted, I think, with
no,
one
ma'am.
Single score or one single test scores if they are not good. Okay, Pranjal, is there any other thing that you want to tell to your juniors or your fellow colleagues, like if they are preparing seriously for the NEET 2020, what all they should do and what should they avoid actually in these days?
What you should do is that you should pick up the last two papers of the NEET, and you should you know, mark the topics that have been asked, and then read those topics from your notes, right? And you should make it at least read those topics, revise those topics two or three times before the exam. And what you should not do is that you should not go for anything fancy or anything new at this stage. You should already, you should, you know, look to be, you know, have a more straight approach now, and you should read high yield and concise stuff rather than going for lots of stuff and lots of new stuff and lots of big stuff. So
means you should always reduce the clutter on your
yes,
table,
ma'am.
Focus on your notes, I think it should be your last
yes,
month's
ma'am.
Strategy. Like what else should they do in these last days if we are actually concentrating on NEET 2020? Because these people are looking forward to you, Pranjal, that actually what we should do and what we should not do in order to get a good score in NEET 2020. So any advice for that?
Yes, ma'am. Firstly, I would like to say that you should always believe in yourself, because if you don't believe in yourself, then you've already lost half the battle. So even if you have not performed well up till now, up in the grand test or in any exam, it's okay. It's the past. You should, you know, always look to move on and look at what is coming at you rather than what you have already left behind in the past, right? You can't change it anyway. But what you can do is you can change the future. And the first step of changing your future is to have self-belief. You know, you should always tell yourself that you are the best, even if you don't believe it, but you should always tell it to yourself. That is the first message that I want to put out there, is that to stay positive. And I mean, these are very stressful times, I know, but you should always try to stay positive. And the second thing I want to say is that you should, like I said, the revision is the key now. You don't go for any new drugs, don't go for any new updates. The NEET people, they ask you basic stuff which you have already read. It's just a matter of the fact that you can't recall that in the examination, because you might not have revised that topic thoroughly, or you just can't recall it at the moment. And the only way you can get over this error of this recall error is by having multiple revisions. I think I can't stress on this enough, that revision, multiple revisions of high yield and select topics rather than single revision of many topics is important. You get it right. Only multiple revisions of high yield topics and select topics is what I want to say, that it's important.
I think golden words by Pranjal. He rightly said that self-belief is the most important thing. If you are not believing in yourself, you can't do anything. And if you believe in yourself, and anything is possible and nothing is impossible. So, okay, Pranjal, how did the journey with DBMCI helped you achieve these scores, the awesome scores that you have got?
So, ma'am, the thing is that there are some subjects at which I was very weak at. Anatomy is probably my weakest subject. So, I attended Dr. Ashwini's class in TND, and I think it really helped me a lot, because I just wasn't able to visualize anything. And you know, the way he makes those diagrams and the way he explains us stuff in the class, that is really helpful, because anatomy has so many questions and so many derived questions come from anatomy that it really helps a lot. And then again, I would after that I attended Dr. Praveen's TND. He's a great teacher. Apart from his TND, I have been following him on Facebook for the past 3 years now, and he posts so many updates, so many high yield tables from Robbins and other books, that I think everyone should make a note of what is being updated by the faculty during initial phase of your preparation, not now, right, in initial phase of your preparation. And then also very close to the exam, he posted a video on the topic of blood banking, which I feel is very important for the Central Institute examinations, and I feel it will gain some importance in the upcoming NEET exam as well, right? Okay. So, ma'am, that and again, Dr. Sushil, his orthopedics class was also really nice. His tests and discussion notes are very crisp, and he also posts so many questions on Facebook, and I think that also helped me,
Yeah, so you were there on DBMCI Premier Group, Pranjal.
Yes, ma'am.
And you used to follow these updates. They were useful for you?
Yes, ma'am. These updates are very useful. But like I said, now is not the time to go for updates. Now is there's only time for revision. Please don't try to learn anything new. Try to memorize new stuff. Whatever you know is enough to crack NEET. You just need multiple revisions of what you know. Because I'm sure by now you must have realized that, okay, fine, I know this question in the exam, I'm just unable to recall it. And the only way, like I've said previously, that you can overcome this recall error is by having multiple revisions. That is the key message that I can't stress on this enough.
Okay, so I think Pranjal is wanting to say that one thing, you should have self-belief in yourself. Don't worry about the past scores. Don't get distracted by the past scores. Now be motivated. Be all prepared for your next exam. Revision is the key to the success. Don't increase your burden now. No new things. Reduce the clutter on the table. Revise and focus on your notes. Now, Pranjal, $1 million question. Can our scores be dramatically improved or changed if you start working very efficiently in this last few days? A very important question on behalf of all the students.
See, it is definitely possible if you do smart and selected study of in the important topics. It is very much possible. Like I told you, that when I gave a PGI mock, I had a rank of 700 or 800, and I was really disappointed by that. And even in the AIMS mocks, I used to get ranks of like 200, 300 something. So I was not performing that well. But I think if you are smart on the day of the examination, and if you are smart in those 3 hours, and if you just trust your knowledge and mark those some extra questions in the exam, and you know, trust your knowledge, so then you can definitely change your rank. But it's very important to stay smart in the exam and have a strategy for the exam as well. Like before you're going into the exam, you should have a clear cut idea. Okay, fine, this is how much I am looking to mark. If the paper is easy, this is how much I can mark. This is the amount of chances that I'm willing to take, and these are the risks that I am willing to take in the exam in order for me to secure a good rank. I mean, these things matter a lot because they can change your marks by like even 5 or 10 marks, and that can
change a whole lot of your rank.
Yeah, ranks by
hundreds. So what he wants to say that not only your hard work and perseverance pays, also those minutes or hours of the examination hall, how you are spending. And it is rightly said that examination is not just the test of your academic knowledge.
Yes.
Also your patience, your skills, your art of doing MCQs, how you are handling all these things.
Yes.
So that is also very important, and that is why we people are keep on posting on the videos that how to do those questions and how many questions to mark.
Yes.
So what do you say, like when you are not sure of a question, that how should we decide that whether to attempt on this question or should we leave this question?
There are two possible scenarios, right? Like one is that you don't know the question at all.
Okay.
And you should not waste any time on this question, because there's no possible way in the world that you will be able to answer the question if it's a single liner and you have never read the topic. But what we tend to do is that we keep on looking at that question and keep on wondering this, okay fine, mujhe kya answer aa jayega. That is not the case.
Hmm.
But instead of that, you should focus on simple questions, but simple yet twisted questions, you know, the ones that you get wrong and the ones that other people will get right, and then that will kind of decide your rank in the end.
Hmm.
So that is what I want to say.
So he wants to say that if you have no clue about the question,
yes,
don't
ma'am.
Waste the time, don't take
yes,
a risk
ma'am.
There. But if you have read that topic, you know that topic, but the options are slightly tilted, twisted, and you are kind of having a dilemma, then you can start with the diagnosis of exclusion.
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Start excluding the options. And if you are able to reach to one possible thing that, yes, this can be the answer, then you can take a risk.
Yes,
okay. So how much percentage you feel that how many percentile of questions you should attempt to get a decent score?
So ma'am, okay, so I'll talk about AIIMS first, because that is the exam that I've given. So in AIIMS I attempted 281 out of 288 questions.
Okay.
And in PGI
that is a pretty very good score, I think. 281 out of 288.
No, not the score, like these are the questions I attempted.
Score of the questions
that you attempted.
Yeah.
And in PGI, but now in AIIMS you have to mark more, right?
Yeah.
But in PGI I think you have to adapt a conservative approach, right?
Yeah,
because
each of the one is having,
each option is evaluated, and each
yes.
option, you know, has a very higher negative score, right? And in NEET again, I think like AIIMS, it is an exam where you have to go aggressive, and for anyone to do very well, I think 280 out of 300 questions are a bare minimum. If you like,
yeah,
you know, want to score
to get
really
a
well.
Decent score, you should achieve at least
because
280 of the
yes,
questions.
Yes, because you will get, I think, 60-70 questions you will get wrong. It's even from topics that you know you will make silly mistakes, there are some guesses you will take. So these questions you will get wrong anyway. So you should always hope to get around 220 to 225 questions correct in order to get a good score in NEET. And in order for that to happen, you have to attempt, you have to keep the human error factor in mind and attempt
yes.
at least 280 questions, at least, yeah.
Okay, any advice upon like how to attempt the paper, which question, like you should do the question paper in order, or you should first start doing the easy questions that you know first? What do you think?
So actually with the exam being online, I think you should do the paper in order only, because then you don't waste time on flipping through the questions. If you know,
okay.
you just flip through the question, then you'll waste some time on flipping, browsing as well, right? So I think if you do it in order, that is very well, that's a good technique. And if you don't know a question, just skip it, move on. You just have to move on. You don't get stuck to one question.
Okay.
If you think that, okay, fine, you're confused in this question, then mark that answer for review. And once you have finished the paper, then just come back to it and analyze it with, you know, a calmer mind.
Okay, so he wants to say that it's better that to go in order, but you can obviously bookmark the questions
yes,
that
ma'am.
You are not confident about,
yes,
and you can keep the time for it to come back and review them, and don't attempt the question if you are not knowing, if you do not have any clue about that question.
Yes,
okay, Pranjal, any other takeaway message that you would like to give to your friends that they should do and they should not do?
Yes, so again, you have to believe in yourself. Thing is that if I can do it, anyone who is watching this video can do it, because I'm not a very smart student anyway. So if I can do it, all of you can do it. It's just about believing in yourself, being true to yourself, and being disciplined in your approach. That is the most key message. You have 20 days, I think 20-25 days for NEET. Make every minute, make every second of it count. You know, don't waste your time so that you regret it later. Just be true to yourself, revise and re-revise, and I'm sure miracles will definitely happen.
Oh, that's so nice of you. I think a very $1 million advice, very good advice given by him. Don't waste your time, self-belief,
yes,
motivational,
ma'am.
And revise.
Also, just please stop using Facebook and WhatsApp now,
focus.
And Instagram also, just don't use it near the exam.
Focus on your notes, don't waste your time, and everybody wastes the time in a different way.
Yeah.
I think please review how you are wasting your time and try to conserve the time. Thank you so much, Pranjal.
Thank
Wish you,
you
a very bright career ahead. Thank you, Pranjal.
Ma'am.
Thank you.